Hello guys, and welcome back to my channel where I show you everything I know about camera, tech and drones. And today we're gonna be jumping right into this comparison between the Sony 90mm f2.8 versus the new release Tokina 100, also f2.8 macro lens. We're gonna be testing image quality, autofocus speed and macro capabilities. I'm gonna be showing you sample videos so you can decide for yourself which lens might be the right for you. And then at the end, I'm gonna be telling you, in my opinion, which lens I think you should consider buying. If I can give you a spoiler alert, I'm gonna be returning to B&H, one of these two lenses. I'm gonna tell you which one and why in a second. So let's get right into the video. Before we begin, guys, if you're new to this channel and you like camera, tech, and drones, click the subscribe button and notification bell so you don't miss out any of our videos. Now, I did a full review on each individual lens, and you can check it out down in the description below. But the way I did the comparison, I put each lens on my Sony A7 R3 and put both on a tripod to get the footage more stabilized. And that takes us to the first difference between these two lenses, because with the Sony lens, you have internal image stabilization that you can turn on and off with just a click of a button, something that the Tokina lens doesn't have, and it only relies on the Sony camera stabilized sensor. With the Sony lens, also you get extra button on the actual lens that you can assign to any function that you want within the camera. It has a focus limiter button that can help tell the camera how far or close you are from your subject, which is super helpful, especially when you're doing very close-up shots. And lastly, the Sony lens has a feature where you can slide forward the focus ring for manual or autofocus selection within the lens itself without having to dig with the menu system. Let me give you an example here so you can see what a big difference these extra customizable buttons on the lens do. On this example, I was trying to focus on the basketball net with the Sony lens, so I put the focus limiter on my Sony all the way to 0.2 meters, and I nailed to focus on the image on the first try. However, with the Tokina, it took me a couple of tries before I was able to focus on the actual net, because the Tokina kept focusing on the wall instead. All of these features on the Sony lens sound amazing, right? But we have to remember here though that the Sony is an $1,100 lens versus the Tokina, which only costs $600, and that's a big of a difference. All right, let me focus now on durability. While the Tokina feels good, especially for the price, you can definitely feel that there's a difference once you hold both lenses on your hands. The Sony lens feels a little bit more premium than the Tokina. The Tokina feels a little more plastic and not as robust as the Sony lens, so I would definitely handle with more care the Tokina lens than the Sony lens. So in terms of durability, the Sony is a clear winner. Next is the way both lenses feel once you mount it on your camera. Here the Tokina wins by a long shot because it just feels more balanced than the Sony lens, and that's either on my Sony A7 III or my Sony A6400. You can tell that there's a weight difference between these two lenses, and the Sony is more front heavy than the Tokina by far. So if you want to travel light, I think the Tokina will be the clear winner. Now let's talk about video autofocusing. I did some basic testing on both lenses, and I was quite pleased actually with both, the Tokina and the Sony. My first test was tracking a human face, and they actually did a pretty good job focusing on my face. I really didn't feel like one was faster than the other. I think both, in my opinion, did a decent job. If I have to pick one here, I think the Sony was a little bit better and snappier than the Tokina, but actually focusing on a face, they both actually did a pretty good job. Also, as you can see here, that even when you're focusing on one object to another, I really didn't feel like a big difference with either lens, and I think both were doing a pretty good job. However, when you're focusing on a macro level and you move the camera from one place to the other, the Tokina could not find focus at all, and the Sony was a clear winner. You can see that even at a macro distance, the Sony was able to find focus, something that the Tokina could not do. Let me show you here another example so you can see both lenses trying to focus on a macro distance, so you can decide for yourself which one looks better. And finally, if you're doing video work with any of these lenses, you have to be aware of the sound they make, especially with the Tokina, which is very noticeable. Let me show you an example here so you can see the noise they make when focusing.
Now for the image test, I took some macro pictures at different f-stops to see how sharp they both are and how much detail you can get on a macro level. We're going to first look at some shots taken with the Tokina, then I will show you others taken with the Sony, and we'll be zooming in on images all the way to 200%. Let's take a look. Alright guys, I can tell you right now that both lenses looked amazing. You can see how much detail you can get with a macro lens, but the Sony, in my opinion, was way sharper in the center than the Tokina lens. Tell me what you guys think down below, I would love to hear what you guys think. Alright guys, unfortunately I had to return one of these two lenses, even though they're both amazing, especially the Tokina for the price. However, it was actually the Tokina lens that I had to return, because how inconsistent it was with autofocus and overall functionality. I had to constantly turn on and off the camera to make the lens work, and there were times where it made the camera freeze completely, until I removed the lens and put another one in to make it work. The Tokina made the camera constantly say that the lens was not recognized and I could not use it. Other times, like I mentioned in my previous video, the lens would extend all the way, but it wouldn't retract back to its original position until minutes later, then it decided to do it on its own. I'm not sure if I got a bad copy or what, but the Tokina was too inconsistent for me to keep. Alright guys, that's it for today. Click the like button if you like this video, and don't forget to subscribe for more camera, tech, and drone reviews. Thanks for watching.